There are a lot of integration methods in complex analysis, and it can sometimes be really hard to determine which one to use. And that is why I created this flowchart here, which will help you to pick the right method each time. And today I'm going to show you how to use it. So let's get going. So the process I would like you to apply anytime you're going to solve a contour integral is the following. The first thing you will have to do is to determine if the contour gamma is a simple closed contour. If no, then you have to check if the antiderivative exists on the contour gamma. And if that also is a no, then you're going to have to use parametrization. But if the antiderivative exists on gamma, then you can instead use independence of path. But let's say that you're dealing with a simple closed contour, then you're instead going to have to check if a function is analytic on and inside the contour. If yes, then you can use Cauchy's integral theorem. And if no, then you're going to have to check how many singularities you're dealing with. If you only have one singularity inside the contour, then you can use either Cauchy's integral formula or Cauchy's residue theorem. But if you have multiple singularities inside the contour, then you can only use Cauchy's residue theorem. And now to really get the hang of this flowchart, we will continue by doing some examples. In this example here, we can see that the contour is not a simple closed contour. And then we can see that since we are dealing with C as our function, the antiderivative will exist on the whole contour. And therefore we can solve this contour integral by using independence of path. In our next example, we can see that the contour is a simple closed contour. And we can also see that the function has a singularity at C is equal to 1. So the function is not going to be analytic on and inside the contour. But since it only had one singularity inside of a contour, we can therefore solve it by using either Cauchy's integral formula or Cauchy's residue theorem. If we instead had two singularities, which is going to be the case in our next example, then the start would be exactly the same as last time. We are still dealing with a simple closed contour, and the function is not analytic on and inside the contour because of the singularities. And since we have two of them, we are going to have to use Cauchy's residue theorem. In our next example, we can see that the contour gamma is a simple closed contour, and the function will be analytic on and inside the contour since we don't have any singularities. And therefore we can use Cauchy's integral theorem to solve this one. In our next example, I will show you how to use the flowchart when you are dealing with loops. Here I would like you to remember that loops are just a union of simple closed contours, so we can simply split the contour up into two parts. And therefore we can rewrite our contour integral up here to the following. And now we can simply use the flowchart for each integral one at a time. For the first integral we can see that the contour gamma 1 is a simple closed contour, but the function will not be analytic inside and on the contour since we have a singularity at C is equal to 1. But since we only have one singularity inside the contour, we can choose to use either Cauchy's integral formula or Cauchy's residue theorem to solve this one. And for the second integral we have that the contour gamma 2 is a simple closed contour, and the function is going to be analytic inside and on the contour since we don't have any singularities in this case. And therefore we are going to be able to use Cauchy's integral theorem to solve this one. So this flowchart will help you to solve any contour integral, but we are now going to expand this flowchart since, as you might remember, complex analysis also covers how to solve certain kinds of real integrals. And the way to solve real integrals in complex analysis is that you rewrite them as a contour integral and then you continue by solving that one instead. And most of the time you will do this by using Cauchy's residue theorem. And with that the flowchart is complete. Now you can use it to solve any integral in complex analysis. So until next time, thanks for watching.